from the Alexa spot.
Yes.
Your program, you can see that there are no more Kwashiorkor children on the streets. You can see that everything country forward. All we need is progress. All we need is prosperity. All we need is development. We want the country to be one nation, one unity, for peace and justice. Thank you.
Order. Please, I want you people to sing for our mommy.
Huge numbers to re-elect President Muhammadu Buhari in the presidential election of February 23rd, 2019. The world held this declaration clearly, and leaders of nations all over the planet have been congratulating not just the president-elect, but Nigerians in general. With the election over and the winner declared, a natural consequence is that differences along political party lines will vanish for another 4 years until it is again time to return to the polls. So even though President Buhari contested and was voted for as a candidate of the All Progressive Congress, APC, he will be inaugurated as a president of Nigeria come May 29, and he will be the leader of all. Similarly, the candidates of the other political parties contested as candidates of their respective parties, but the declaration of a winner has reverted them back to their most important role as citizens of Nigeria, stakeholders who must continue to give their best for the country. It does not matter that they play this role as partners with the government that will be sworn in, or that they productively engage this government as a viable opposition. With this configuration in mind, the foremost opposition candidate in the election, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, not to shy away from playing this role. This requires that he is seen as putting the interests of Nigeria first, a requirement that has been made even more important by unscrupulous persons waiting in the wings to exploit any contentions over the polls to their own dark advantage. Fortunately for Nigeria, our democracy, though still young, has continued to evolve in ways that reassure us that things can only get better. One such leap is the development in 2015, when the then President Goodluck Jonathan called to congratulate the then winner of the presidential election. Even before the vote tally was completed, they singularly acted. That singular act of patriotism is today hailed as the benchmark of the level of statesmanship befitting of candidates in our election. May God bless President Goodluck Jonathan, the hero of our modern democracy. This has become a modern democratic culture in Nigeria, for which former President Jonathan will continue to receive accolade. Had he acted contrary at this time, perhaps democracy growth in Nigeria may have been stunted and even truncated. But thankfully, he set the benchmark, a standard that we today expect from anyone that takes part in the presidential election. We therefore call on Alhaji Atiku Abubakar to emulate the statesmanship of President Jonathan and quit his ongoing disruptive stance on the election. There has been a series of calls on him to call and congratulate President Buhari as the winner of the election, which would infer that he would be, by consequence, give up any legal challenge of the election result. We attempted to align with the first half of this demand that Atiku calls President Buhari to offer his congratulatory message. But we will not suggest that he forfeit his right to seeking judicial redress. He is very free to approach the court to ventilate his grievances. What is unacceptable, however, is the adoption of positions and making of utterances that are being interpreted by his supporters and party members as a call to violence. We have become aware that his supporters are strategizing for violent protests that they are targeting to cause chaos nationwide and bring down the government. Some of Atiku's lieutenants and political associates are subtly encouraging such protests through comments they have been making in the mainstream media and their social media accounts. The hostile environment being created by Atiku's stance has been made even tenser by his reported demands on President Buhari made through the National Peace Committee. Such behavior suggests an opposition that he has transmuted into a dictatorship. One that is hell-bent on blackmailing the country to impose itself on the people when it has been clearly rejected at the poll. This is not acceptable at a time when Nigerians expect that they had to govern the country will at the very least imbibe the spirit of sportsmanship championed by former President Jonathan. Our democracy comes first because the personal fixation of any politician. We insist that the peace accord signed by political parties and their candidates, including Atiku, must be respected. Nigeria truly deserves peace and stability at this point in time, which is why we are holding this 2 million women rally for democracy in Nigeria to demand for national stability and peace in Nigeria. It is our own way of sending a clear message to the thugs, urchins, and miscreants that have been mobilized to cause chaos in the country that we will take them on in the streets as mothers, wives, daughters, and ultimately as Nigerians. We have mobilized our members across the country and we are able to counter anyone or group of persons threatening Nigerians' democracy wherever they may spring up. Truth be told, by nature and character, we are out for peace, and only peace we want to achieve in this country.
Yes.
While we remain a political group, we are encouraged by the assessment of International Election Observation Mission, which in spite of their earlier tilt in favor of Atiku prior to the election, have come out to declare that the conduct and the outcome of the poll was satisfactory to them. We suggest that Atiku takes time to slow down and listen to his foreign allies, who have now concluded that even the parallel vote tabulation they have used as control showed that PDP candidate was fairly defeated. We use this opportunity to passionately appeal to President Buhari and Nigerians not to repose their confidence in him for nothing. The second term they have given him in office should not become a basis for miscreants to destabilize the country in the guise of protesting for their candidate that fairly lost in an election. Why, Mr. President, must continue to urge his supporters to be civil in their jubilation at his victory and contemplative of the tasks ahead. Members of the opposition must also be reminded that Nigeria has laws and law enforcement agencies must be so instructed. Again, we want to appeal to our father and friends and friend Alhaji Atiku Abubakar to do the needful now. Pick up the phone and call President President Buhari, let's sustain the peace and stability for our nation. Tell him you congratulate him. We demand that singular phone call that can keep Nigerians peace, that kept Nigerian peace in 2015. We demand that phone call now. In this 2019, let Nigeria come first at all times. Yes. Great women of Nigeria.
In the 2019 project, may I invite Mrs. Princess Chief Lillian Eteke.
God has answered our prayers. We members of the Paramount Major will work. As you can see here, our members and all other family members are here to rejoice for God has done it for us and He will continue to do it for us.
What are your expectations in the next level?
My expectation is Baba will do more than what he has done. Baba has fixed the economy. He has driven away the insurgents. He has fought the corruption. So Baba will do more than that. Before Baba leaves, Nigeria will become the new leaf.
Okay, the opposition party is continuing to go to Canada.
No, we don't have any fear because this is the most credible election Nigeria has ever conducted. We have advised them to join hands with Baba to move the country forward.
What's your name?
My name is Ambassador Fatima Adams, National Coordinator of Women for Buhari.